These are the people of New Jack City, a new feature by Warner Brothers about an old problem, drugs and the people it draws to it. New Jack City can be in any state there's drugs. This particular New Jack City is in Harlem. One of the stars of the movie is rapper Ice-T, who is an undercover cop fighting drug lord Nino Brown.
This is the American way.
It's about a bad guy, gangster, who just came up on crack early when crack was coming out in 86. He decided he was going to turn it into big business. And he's using all business techniques of marketing and expanding. And I'm an Afrocentric cop that doesn't like the rules, New Jack cop. I'm new to it. I don't like all the rules, but I know how to get to this guy. Judd Nelson plays a white guy from Howard Beach who they bring in just to really give me problems. But he makes me aware that, yo, it's not a white thing or a black thing. It's a death thing. What I think is great about the movie, it lets you hear the side of the mentality of the drug dealer, who, when you listen to him talk, sounds like any big business entrepreneur. You know, he sounds like, hey, I'm just trying to get money. This is capitalism. This is the American way. What makes me any different than any of these other companies that are killing people, poisoning the atmosphere, and hurting streams?
When you were growing up, did you live some of the things that happened in the movie, or were you experienced some of those?
Not so much the drug part of it, but just, you know, the vibe you get off the streets and the seduction of the crime game, you know. Like, I was very early introduced to it and saw the money and the cash flow, and I saw the Nino Brown characters, and that's who I wanted to be when I was growing up. And I was pretty much on my way to being a Nino Brown. I mean, when I got snatched out of the crime game, I was pretty successful. I had a car, I had jewelry, I had clothes, I had girls, you know, and I understand the seduction of the criminal element, you know.
What turned it around for you?
I was just lucky. I was rapping something I just picked up, you know, something I was doing just for fun, you know, to get girls. And I was in a club and a movie came in there. The producers decided they wanted to use me as a rapper. I didn't want to be in their movie because I felt they were just going to exploit me and all that kind of stuff. But my friends told me, they said, Ice, go for it, man. Go for it. You got a chance to get on the other side, homeboy. White people like you, man. You know? And that's, you know, and that kind of shocked me. And they kind of like pushed me. They said, you got to go be in this movie, man. You know? And I did it. And they continued to push me. Now, that was 7 years ago. And since then, all of them have gone to prison. A lot of them are dead, and that was the motivation that kept me in there. You know, every time I say, I can't make it in show business, one of my boys would go to penitentiary.
Hey, listen. I've been authorized to set up an independent drug-fighting unit, and I'm picking you. Got it?
Why me?
Why you, man? You from the neighborhood? I can trust you, and I know you give. So what's the catch? There's no catch, man. Why you gotta say that?
Because I know your ass, Stone.
Freddy here goes with you. This big biscuit head looking...
Hey, listen up, Scotty. It's not going to be another one of your wild-ass solo acts, man. Now, Freddy is the only cop I could find crazy enough to even team up with you.
But you were really kind of a natural in the role.
See, sometimes people say things like that, and then I start blushing on TV, and this is not cool. Hey, I just did it. I don't know as far as acting is, but I'm a very honest person, and I don't try to put any extra on it. And I think maybe when a bad actor is when he tries to put extra on it. I just read the line, and that's how it is. And I'm not trying to give you a Shakespearean recital. I'm just saying, they say, I say, who's that? I look at the camera and say, who's that? And then they, oh, that's natural, you know, who's that? Okay, who is that? That's bad acting. Music is what I am. I'm a rapper, you know what I'm saying? I'm trying to act. If you think I can act, that's great. I'm trying to act. I gotta make a few more films before I believe I can act. I think there's one story I got from an interviewer that I think I should share with people. It's like, there was one interviewer who said, he went in the movie, he sat there with his 14-year-old kid, and he said, I don't like this movie. This is a critic. His kid said, that's how it is, Dad. I don't like it, but that's how it is. And he said he was driving home, and then it just hit him in the middle of the road. He said, he looked at his kid, he said, is that how it is? And his kid said, that's how it is. And he said the movie changed his whole life because he didn't realize how uptight and bitter he was just about kids with gold chains and just the whole imagery you see. But his son, it's a white guy, his son was saying, Pops, I know Nino Brown. I know they go to my school, you know. And he talked and he said his whole life has changed. And so he's getting 10 autographs from me now. And he says, man, I would never wanted to meet you before, but now I understand where you're coming from. And I think if you go in there with the attitude and open up, you'll see something that maybe you haven't seen. You might understand what's going on in our streets.
You know, a drug dealer is the worst kind of brother, man. Yeah. He won't give it to his sister, he won't give it to his mother, but he'll sell it to one of his boys on the streets. I don't know about you, but I'm ready to kill Nino, man. Are you with me?
I'm ahead of you.